One of the critical things about getting the conversation right when you make the diagnosis is because you're going to have a long-term relationship with the patient for months or years and maybe for the rest of their life. I think it's very important that you have patients' confidence and that they're confident you are an expert in the condition. Because systemic sclerosis is a rare disease, the patients have actually had their symptoms for quite a significant time often by the time they get to us in the specialised clinic. When I tell a patient that they have systemic sclerosis, where they've maybe never heard of the disease, I would see it as a success if they left the room with a clearer idea about the disease and perhaps less frightened. My advice to patients, though, is that they do have to respect systemic sclerosis. You can't go on living your life as if it's not there, but I think you can try and make reasonable adjustments. And so one of the terms that I think patients find helpful is to discuss the concept of pacing their activity. This is a very variable disease that causes appearance changes and physical changes in the skin. As well as its effects on the outside, the disease can affect the internal organs. We have to look carefully at the heart, the lungs, the kidney, sometimes the bowel. Patients often present short of breath, and then it is very much a case of trying to work out through your investigations how the scleroderma is causing that, and in particular, of course, whether there is evidence of a major lung complication such as pulmonary hypertension or lung fibrosis. And that's why we would be doing routine tests of all patients. I think then the patient will understand that we're being thorough rather than trying to cause undue anxiety. I've been looking after systemic sclerosis patients now for more than 25 years. I think that we're better at managing many of the symptoms and we're starting to make an impact on some of the life-threatening complications. It's been very positive to see that pulmonary hypertension has become more treatable and starting to emerge are treatments that are more effective for the skin disease and potentially for the lung fibrosis. And so my hope is that that will be translated into real long-term clinical benefit for patients.